Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how to install MySQL 8.0.25 on Windows using MySQL installer. So the first step is to download this installer. That's why I need to go to the navigator and here I have to type MySQL. Then let's go to this first link and let's click on downloads. Now let's scroll down and let's click on MySQL community downloads. In this page, we have to click on this link, MySQL Installer for Windows. Then in this page, we have to download this installer, which has this size, which means that this installer does not need an internet connection during the installation step. So let's download it. In this page, I don't need to log in or to sign up. I have just to click on this link. No thanks, just start my download. Now, as you can see, I can save this installer on my computer, but in my case, I have already downloaded it, so I will cancel this download and I will use the installer that I have already downloaded, which is this one. So let's start it. Now in this window, as you can see, we have several options for the installation. We can install MySQL for developers, we can install the server only, we can install the client only, we can install everything, or also we can customize the installation. So, of course, we need to install the server, because the server will save our databases. But also it is a good idea to install the client workbench, which allows us to see the content of the databases using a user interface. For this reason, I will select custom and then I will install the server plus the client workbench. So let's click on next. And here let's select the MySQL server and let's add it to the list of the products that will be installed. Then we have to select the client workbench and we have also to add it to this list. Now let's click on next. And here it is mentioned that it is necessary to install Visual Studio Redistributable. So we will allow MySQL installer to download and to install this redistributable. That's why I will click on execute. Now the redistributable will be installed, so I have to check this box and to click on install. So the installation of this redistributable finished successfully, so I will click on close to close this window and then I have to click on next. Now these two products will be installed, so let's click on execute. Now the installation finished successfully, but we still need to provide some configurations, so let's click on next. Let's click on next again. In this window, we have several default configurations that we will accept, and then we have to click on next. Here we have to select this option, which is already selected, so let's click on next. So now we need to provide the password for the root user, so I will provide a password that I can remember, and of course I need to repeat it for the confirmation. Now it is optional to add a new user. We don't need to do this for the moment, but I will just add a new user to show you how to do this. So let's click on add user, and this user I will call it admin. Then I have to provide a password that I can remember, and I need to confirm this password. Now let's click on OK to add the user, and let's click on next. So in this window, it is mentioned that MySQL will be started when the system starts. So this is good. And let's click on next. Now let's click on execute. Now MySQL is configured correctly. So let's click on finish. Let's click on next. And here I don't like to start MySQL workbench automatically. So for this reason, I will uncheck this box. I will show you later how to start MySQL Workbench. So let's click on Finish to close this window. Now it is necessary to add the path of MySQL to the environment variables. For this reason, I have to open the location where I installed MySQL, which is on Program Files in a folder called MySQL. Then I have to open this folder and then I have to go to the bin folder. So here I have this MySQL executable. Now I need to copy this path and to add it to the environment variables. So let's go to the environment variables. And now let's go to advanced system settings and let's click on environment variables. And here I have to find the path variable, which is this one. So let's edit it. And at the beginning of this value, I will paste the path of MySQL to provide it with the highest priority. And also I need to add a semicolon as the separator between the different paths. So let's click on OK, OK again. And let's click on OK to close this window. And let's close this window. Now let's open a command prompt and in this window I will just type the following command mysql minus minus version. As you can see, now MySQL is recognized and the version that I have is 8.0.25. Now let's connect to MySQL server. So I will use the following command. So MySQL minus U for user, then I have to provide the username, minus P for password, and then I have to hit enter. Now I have to provide the password, and now I am connected to the database. So I will type the following command to show the list of the available databases. And as you can see, for the moment, I have these four databases. So let's create a new database. I will call it my shop. Now let's see again the available databases. And as you can see, the database that I have created is already listed in this list. Now let's exit the connection with the database using exit. We can also close this window. And now let's open MySQL Workbench. So let's go to the location where Workbench has been installed. It is on Program Files MySQL in this folder. And here I have this executable file. So I will create a shortcut of this file on the desktop. And now I can close this folder and on the desktop I have this shortcut. So let's run it. Now in this window, I will just connect to the database using the root user. So I have to click on this button and then I have to provide the password. Let's click on OK. And in this window, as you can see, we have different zones. So this zone, I can hide it using this button. And this area, I can hide it using this button. Now in this area, I can click on Schema to see the available databases. And as you can see, the database that I have created using the command prompt is already listed here. So this is all for this video. In the next video, I will show you how to use MySQL Workbench. Thank you very much for watching and please subscribe to the channel.